Hi everyone, I'm Ben, and this is the Board Game Blueprint. This week, we're going to talk about print and plays, or P&Ps as they're affectionately referred to online for quick, abbreviated typing. A print and play is essentially a printable version of a game that can be downloaded and then printed out and decked out or playtested with, often gathering lots of popularity through Kickstarter for potential backers to actually experience the game before they commit to pledging for their own copy. Print and plays offer a lot of variety, and so again, this week's episode will kind of feature a couple tips and tricks that I've picked up along the way about print and plays that I have either printed out myself and tried, or ones that I've prepared for my own designs. Before we get started, we'll just talk a little bit more about why print and plays are great. If you don't have a certain number of physical copies that you can mail out to every single playtester, blind playtester, reviewer, or potential publisher that you can, a print and play can be a good solution to kind of help remedy that a little bit. When it comes to a print and play, there are definitely considerations to think about, such as whether or not your recipient has the ink and paper necessary to print out all of your components. I would say that print and plays are very common for card games especially, because most of those are paper. But I have seen a couple really cool decked out or deluxified versions of P&Ps that gamers will make all on their own. Usually a P&P for those ones that are going to be kind of souped up anyway, have artwork that the gamer can't normally have access to. But I've also seen kind of more minimal P&Ps, print and plays, where the artwork is in black and white and maybe a lower quality than, of course, the final product. Essentially, it's just to simulate the gameplay experience. And so I myself wouldn't go too far past that route necessarily. Although also presenting a near to finished version can be a great benefit for how you are received by your audience. For those of us in the US, the most popular paper size, I imagine, is the letter, or 8.5 by 11. Normally, you can fit 9 individual cards if you have them laid out in a 3x3 formation, but I'll also show an example later on where we go 2x4, and maybe one reason why you might want to do that, despite losing out on one face of a card. So I'm going to be using Adobe Illustrator, which is one of my favorite programs to work in personally, to put together this P&P. But of course, Inkscape and even Component Studio will be really great for some of this stuff later. In fact, Component Studio, I believe, will automatically generate many of these things for you. So the first thing that I like to do after opening up the program is creating an extra layer or two. This is going to provide me a little bit more flexibility in terms of what I'm going to compose, and so I can actually, on the bottommost layer, apply some cut lines. What I'll do is download a card template from the Game Crafter, whichever size I'd like to use, and copy the cut line into my own file. From here, I'll go ahead and create that grid or format layout of the sheet that I would like printed. And then I will add those cut lines, because when we print out, we're going to want a little bit of a guide to show us where we should go across with our scissors or rotary cutter, slide cutter, etc. I've already generated some cards, so I'll just kind of plop them into place here. Or, well, they've already been plopped into place. And I'll then make sure that that art is on the layer above the cut lines. Again, when printed out, it'll be a flat image, so there won't be any distinction, but this way I don't have the cut lines maybe overlapping the actual art that I want. What I didn't mention is that this video will also kind of be a nice little throwback to our prototype process video from before. Here's my slide cutter here, and here is my printed page. Again, we have the lines going across thusly, and we have some going up and down as well that are maybe a little bit harder to see, but we'll make it work. So for this particular cutter, I'm going to have to line up the cut line here. So I'm going to just kind of lean over and hope for the best. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Oop. We'll make that work a little bit better, but we can see that our cut lines helped guide us to get a really clean cut like this. So let me go ahead and cut out maybe, oops, these other lines out so that I'll have three cards to then show you what we can do next. Doesn't that look clean?